coming out on this rainy Tuesday evening. Our program is entitled Journeys, and it is very fitting, and we'll talk about the many reasons why throughout our evening. But you'll find translations and original texts in the back of your program if you'd like to follow along. There are lots of ways to go on a journey, and go on a spiritual journey, a journey in a relationship, a journey of personal growth, perhaps physical healing, whatever it may be. I hope that at least one, many, maybe more of these texts will touch you in some way, cause you to reflect and think about your own journeys, your own struggles, and your own rewards. The piece you just heard is about an invitation, and that's what we want to offer you just now, an invitation to come along, to taste, see, and smell the many dynamics of this program. Up next is an Irish ballad, a traditional Irish ballad. If you enjoy melancholy at all, I know I just said that, if you enjoy melancholy, you might be Irish. No, just kidding. But this is for you. It's a beautiful Irish ballad, and then followed by a fantastic Korean tune. If you forecast our previous in our set, Sanyu Hwa is a traditional Korean song that means wild mountain flower. This idea of a flower that exists high on a mountaintop, where the flower is both vulnerable to the elements, to a lack of oxygen perhaps, but also the thing that sustains its life is its own strength. And it's this journey that you'll hear in the singers, in their voices, depicting vulnerability and strength back and forth and back and forth in the journey. Next is, however, She Moved Through the Fair.
Thank you.
University is a wonderful place, and all of you who are or have been teachers, at any point you know, it's a strange thing to welcome people into your life knowing that in a set number of years, they will move on. And so here at State Choirs, we want to give thanks always, especially to this group of people here on my left. These are seniors and graduate students who are moving on. And it is good and right to give thanks. And it's good and right to also send them on their way. We love them, and we love them. But other chapters are ahead of them. And it's why they came here. And so to keep them here would be strange. Right? So we want to recognize these folks. As I call your name, just raise your hand so we can recognize you. We'll give a round of applause at the end for all of our graduating students. In no particular order, Alex Jones, Clayburn Molesky, Morgan Moore, Meg Amison, Noah Hill, Kyla Hood, Courtney Moore, Riley Stebbins, Michael Joseph, Dean McDonald, Jess from. Could you help me thank the class? Thank you.
was "I'll Go Alone" by Elizabeth Alexander. This piece has such an interesting origin story. Elizabeth Alexander was asked to compose a song for a concert honoring strong women, with a request that she consider honoring American author, activist, and civil rights leader Coretta Scott King. So to find inspiration, the composer examined the program from Coretta Scott King's funeral, and within this program was a poem written by Evelyn K. Dudley, the woman who served as Coretta Scott King's caregiver during the last year of her life. Dudley wrote this poem years before she knew King, speaking to the struggle of anyone who journeys on despite pain, suffering, and loneliness, be they rich or poor, famous or unsung. This is the poem that inspired the piece that we just performed for you. Beautiful job to our many soloists, and a special thank you to our accompanist, Michonne, who arranged the accompaniment for this piece. Our second piece this evening is Born into a Fairy Tale by Timothy Takache. The composer said of this piece, "Setting Julia Klatzinger's Born into a Fairy Tale was a journey into familiarity, into warmth, into honor, and a small bit of grief. Comparing a life to any of those found in fairy tales, we find that although we were given none of the common fairy tale tropes, both good and bad, our mother has instead given us the only thing we really need at the beginning of our lives, love." Please enjoy Born into a Fairy Tale.
Knowing not to be.
Chagulia by Dr. Zenaida Stewart Robles. You will notice that we only say one word during this whole entire song, Kuchi Chagulia. This is the second principle of Kwanzaa, meaning self-determination. The composer explained that Kwanzaa principles are valuable to remember year-round and encourages choirs to perform this piece at concerts throughout the year. Following Kuchi Chagulia, our final Scarlet Voices piece of the evening, is the traditional spiritual I'm On My Way, as performed by Mahalia Jackson and arranged by Anthony Tresick King. Generally, spirituals are known for being heavy and somber pieces due to their connections to the African-American enslavement. Although the words of this piece carry with them strong connections to traditional spirituals and coded language for escaping to the North, the musical style divests from the traditional style. This is because in the 1950s, famous gospel singer Mahalia Jackson, who is known for incorporating new styles into gospel music, created her version of this piece, adding an Afro-Cuban beat. In this piece, we contemplate a journey toward freedom and liberation. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
journeys. Like I was saying about our graduating students who come to A-State, they grow, and with experience and their skill set, they go off to another chapter where they again grow and gain experience. Sometimes that also happens with faculty. As some of you may know, Dr. Colleen McNichol is doing exactly that. She is relocating with her family to the Detroit, Michigan area. And that is too long, we decided it was too long of a commute. So it is right for us to say a few words for Dr. McNichol. So here's the thing about goodbyes. I don't do goodbyes. I only do see you later. Thank you for all that you have given this program and for our music education students here at Utah State. From you, they have learned kindness and balance and to think of the whole self, to be structured and creative, to be good to yourself and to laugh at yourself, and most of all, to love yourself. On a personal note, thank you for being a fantastic colleague, where respect is given because it should be, without question, for being encouraging, for challenging me, and for most of all, for supporting me and my family and me with joy. We have some small tokens of gratitude for you, both from Scarlet Voices and from the A-State Choir as a whole. There's even something in there to help with a homewarming present as you get used to your new chapter. We hope you can take part of us with you, because we will be keeping part of you here with us. Dr. Nichol, thank you. Not until August 26th. it's a lovely ensemble, and there's choir is a special place. Just say it that way. It has a very, very low threshold to enter. All you need is your body. Yeah? And everyone sings. No matter what you say, everyone sings. Right? And so if you would like to be part of something like Jones Brook Choir, we would love to have you. Just see me in the lobby after the concert or talk to one of these fine folks. Our set in this next ensemble, again, on the theme of journeying, is about walking. We're actually going to open with two spirituals by the very famous and departed arranger Moses Cohen, about the two spirituals about walking. And they relate to the African-American experience in where both the religious and political struggle was directly connected and expressed through their music. And then we move on to a piece that's commissioned by Governor of Yucatan in Mexico. It's about the traveler experience, the refugee experience, sort of in a love of homeland way. And then finally, we'll close with another piece Arts here in Northeast Arkansas and wherever you call home. It is one of the things that makes us us, music and the arts, right? If you'd like to see this, then support the arts and music in schools as well. Because this does not happen without fantastic music education happening, starting with our itty-bitties. So thank you for all